Sergeant Singer. Where are you from?
Oh, from a very long way away. Saarland. And Saarland is now occupied by the Frenchies.
Then we'll boot them out, yes?
Yes.
Well, what really attracted me to this particular story was the fact that it was so simple. And it's a true story, which was told to Thomas Hardy, and he then wrote it as an eight-page story. And the fact that it is so simple makes it ideal for a movie.
Mark, who's only two tickets?
I wanted to do certain things with it which were very different. I wanted it to have pace. I wanted the story itself to drive the film on continually from front to end, and also to try and find some positive moments within the film and have a positive ending, which isn't really Hardy.
Ah!
Are
you talking? How long will you be stationed here?
Not long.
Then you must make the most of what time you have here.
Wordsworth.
To me, the romantic lead, there was no other choice than Jean-Marc Barr.
This is a short story by Thomas Hardy called The Tale of the Melancholy Hussar, and I'm playing the German melancholic Hussar who falls in love with an English girl from a country manor. Of course, it's a frustrated love because they're foreigners and because the war is over and they would like to go home.
What if you just ride away from here? From the army, from everything. Damn Bonaparte, he will live in Saarland. And when the war is over, we'll come back here and visit again.
Oh, Mateus, that is like deserting. We won't be caught. I will be branded a soldier's whore and you will be shot.
They gradually fall in love and things change after that. I'll give away the ending.
Just remember, when you grab it, okay, make sure it comes up high. The muzzle has to come up high.
Right.
Over my head.
I think it lends itself wonderfully to film because the simplicity of it also attracted me to it. And within that, you can flesh out the characters, and the simplest, truest emotions are much more universal.
Okay, and action!
It's very rare working with intelligent actresses and actresses that are not worried about how the light's hitting them or, you know, how to tame their egos. You're working with a professional.
Ready.
A fine soldier.
Do I look dashing?
I will. Captain Fairfax, I would say idle dress and put you on a charge.
Poetry! That's true, it is, isn't it? It's poetry! German, but I know what
you can say. The story is very interesting from Fairfax's point of view in that this young German sergeant, this extremely good-looking and gentle and poetic and rather soulful young man is part of the regiment, and Fairfax is completely stopped in his tracks.
It'd be a bitter disappointment to me to have you lose the stripes from your tunic only to gain stripes on your skin.
144, take one.
You have to kind of imagine the character very fully, almost as if he were a character in a novel, and then interact with your fellow players.
I have a lease, a military necessity. You will quit my land.
You are such a stone. We shall make the siege of Jericho seem as a tea time affair. Do I make myself plain?
Your talent, sir.
I like Thomas Hardy stories for a kickoff. You sense fate or society or capitalism or religion or morality like a great engine crushing the heroes and heroines of his books.
You have played the part of a coward and a scoundrel! And if you are any part of a man, I would slap your jaws for you! Now get out of my house!
I And what is an essential feature of Thomas Hardy? It's a very bleak fact. It's the essential feature of Thomas Hardy, which is that one is completely controlled by the gods.
Stop! In the name of His Majesty, stop! It's serious!
The whole project and the cast level and everything has escalated beyond, I think, anyone's belief.
I have to go, Francis. I owe Christoph my life. Come with me and be my wife. For all the world. And to the end of time.
It is a small movie, but it's got very, very big.